Surge Geelong today with Matt Fletcher from Entrepreneurs Geelong. Matt, you've got some exciting news today. What is it that you are here to do primarily today?
Well, it's really exciting. Today, what we're doing is we're launching the Geelong Entrepreneurial Ecosystem Map, or for short, GMAP.
Oh, see, I like a short name.
It's a short name, so gmap.com.au, really easy to kind of roll off. And GMAP is all about actually putting everything on a map that an entrepreneur needs to know about how they get help and support in our region.
So when you say entrepreneur, you're not just talking startups, are we? We're starting to talk about people who are building their business, who are looking to take it to a new level or to launch a new product?
Yeah, absolutely. And it can even go beyond that. I think that there's this mentality of entrepreneur only being business. But we need entrepreneurs in all sorts of areas, whether it be startup business, whether it be in inside organisations, whether it be in our government and not-for-profits, even our community organisations. So how do we get that mindset into that? And this is a way that you can get those resources to start to do that.
So tell me a little bit about how GMAP works, because I know there's been an awful lot of work that's gone into this, and to me it sounds like a really simple idea that you would be able to actually map the kind of services that businesses who are looking to move in our ever-changing environment to be able to access those. Simple, but you know, hasn't been done until now.
No, it is a simple concept, but in the execution it is very difficult. And look, there, you can see all the information. There's a huge range of research and data capture that we've done behind it. A lot of thinking has gone into it. It's very, very structured in the research and the way we've set it up. But at the same time, we've done all that to try and make it as simple as possible for the person who goes, I just want to find out where I can hang out with people that are like me, and to get that type of mentality. So if we can do that, then we've achieved our aim. But there is a lot of work that's gone into that behind the scenes, absolutely.
Now, this is launching today, but it's something that's also pretty exciting for lots of other people. Now, I know we were talking before saying that there's people from around the world who are getting pretty excited about this.
Absolutely. And I mean, it's interesting. I've been talking with people all over Australia and, you know, not just Melbourne, but I'm off to Perth shortly to talk to people there about it, in Brisbane and Adelaide. But also got people talking to me about it from Boston and also in places like Kansas City. So it's a fascinating thing to see how people are grasping this, and all of a sudden they see Geelong in a different light. It's not just a little town or you're somewhere near Melbourne. It's like Geelong has its own identity. It gives it its own personality in the globe and on a world scale. So it's a fascinating thing to be able to do.
And it seems very much like part of that great big world movement of smart ideas for simple problems. You know, how do we find where the funding is? How do we find who does these services in my area? Simple questions, good solution.
Yeah, and it's really about how do we actually listen to people who are out there on the ground and what do they need? I think that a lot of time when people sit in organisations, whether it be in government or other organisations, they tend to talk at their level. But it's really about what do these people need? How do we answer their simple question? Which what we're trying to do is, I need some help. What help can I get? And so what we're trying to do is say, here it is. Here's all the things that might be in the right space for you. And hopefully it's simple, it's straightforward, and it gives you a way to start to move yourself forward in your business or your idea forward.
But it's part of a bigger picture, isn't it? Because this, as much as it's a really exciting first step, and we are genuinely really excited about it, and we want everyone to get on board, that address again was...
GMAP, GEEMAP.com.au.
Fantastic, and we'll link that up at the end as well. But it's also a first step, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. And I think the thing is, we had a sit down a couple of months ago about 6 months ago here at the pier to talk about this. But it was just, this is the start of actually knowing what we've got. And once we know what we've got, then we can start to have a conversation about where should we go and what do we need to get there. And it's not a linear thing. It's not like we are going to be X city. We're not going to replicate anything. That's silly. We are Geelong. We have a great resource here in our region. So it's now about, okay, where do we go from here? What does it look like? What does the future look like? What does the next 5 years, 20 years, 30 years look like? And how do we start to chart that from ourselves, driving it from the community, but also asking of our organisations, our governments, and say, this is what we need to make this happen.
Now, you're actually talking about evidence-based decision-making, aren't you, Matt? Goodness me, you are talking about brand new ideas, aren't you?
It is. I mean, look, I suppose it's never a great thing to talk about in a political sense, but I think that like everything that's good, you need to, I think we talked about it before, everything rises and falls on leadership. And leadership is about not just taking people where you want them to go, it's taking people where they want to go and doing it together. And I think that this has been a great process in itself, even without the map, just to bring all these people into the right space to go, hey, we all want Geelong to be fantastic. We're all playing in the same space. Let's work together. Even if we're in competition, we can do that together, and we can do something absolutely fantastic to make this one of the world's great regional cities.
Oh, fantastic. Well, I certainly hope everyone does get on board this, does get in, get behind it, and does jump online. That address again was?
GEEMAP.com.au.
That's it, GEEMAP.com.au. Thank you, Matt. Pleasure to be here. Enjoy the rest of your day at Emerge Geelong. We have to let him go because he's about to speak. So we're here this morning at Emerge Geelong. We're here with John Paxton, who's the CEO of ICT Geelong. John, this is the fourth in a series of five events that's run through Skilling the Bay, is that right? Can you tell me a little bit about Emerge and the Unconference?
Okay, yes. Emerge Geelong is an Unconference format. As you say, it's number four of a series of five events, which ICT Geelong presented for Skilling the Bay. It's part of the Business Skills Initiative. And this one's a little bit different. It's more a participation. You know, we invite people to come in to participate and to share, ask lots of questions and get really involved. So it's not a slide presentation where it's at you. It's more involvement. And hopefully it'll be a fun day.
No death by slideshow then.
That's right, yeah.
PowerPoints are off the table.
That's right.
What was interesting is when I was looking around the room, there were people on laptops, they were on their phones, they were talking to each other. Mm. And I'm guessing that this is the idea. And it's an innovative idea. Mm, and innovative ideas is what we're here to talk about, isn't it?
Yes, that's right. Well, Todd Hubers is our event director, and he's a board member at ICT Geelong, and he's been fantastic, and he's really put together a great show.
So tell me a little bit about this idea that we were talking about before, that is not startups as a new venture out in a new startup business, but the idea that we need to take on as Australian businesses, new ventures within our organisations, within our not-for-profits, within our business, to do things differently and to use technology, because we aren't doing this very well, are we?
No, there's a recent conference in Sydney, a CBIT conference, and they presented some information around how Australia was rating how Australian business was using technology. And it actually said that Australia is slipping behind. And wow. I think it said we've dropped from 16th in the world to 26th or something like that.
So that's really surprising because Australia is such a, or Australians are such a big take up of technology, digital technology, man. Our use of mobile phones and mobile technology, our internet usage is really, really high in the world. So you're saying that we're using it a lot, we're just not using it in very productive ways.
Yeah, I think Australians are great consumers of technology, but we're not great users of technology. And what ICT Geelong is trying to do is to encourage business to start using the technology to improve their businesses and to improve profitability and employment.
And look, we all know that there are big challenges in the world today and within business. Things change really fast and they're not going to slow down.
No.
How can businesses start to use technology? How can they get over, I guess, this pushback and this sense of going, oh, God, you know, I'm not sure that I can take it on board. I don't understand it. Do I have time? How do we get them to say, you know what, there are solutions out there to problems that we have?
I think that's something that, you know, the board of ICT Geelong has been sort of wrestling with. And what we've come up with is the fact that you've got to start immersing yourself in it. And the whole... Well, one of the major themes that we're pushing is that ICT Geelong is a connector. So it connects users with providers. So it's this networking, getting involved, starting to learn about what technology is available. And ICT Geelong's got the membership base to help. And we've got providers. And what we're doing now is encouraging users to come into the group to actually benefit from the knowledge that's within the group. So we're looking at transforming Geelong, basically. So we're looking at digital Geelong, and we're looking at really driving that through and helping businesses to become users of technology and to reap the benefits of that. Yeah.
Fantastic. And we heard Matt Fletcher earlier talking and launching the GMAP Geelong.
GMAP, yes, indeed.
Which is fantastic. And I think that, you know, that's part of that picture, isn't it, of getting people to understand what is here, how we can use the services here, and perhaps being a little bit surprised about just how much is available here.
Yeah, I think the whole concept of entrepreneurism, I think people have got this concept is it has to be a digital startup to be entrepreneurial, whereas in actual fact, Andrew Hyde, who came out from Boulder and who was a guest of Launch Vic, his definition of a startup is anything new. So that includes obviously a startup, entrepreneurial, digital business, but it also includes SMEs doing something new, the entrepreneurism of big companies like Barwon Health, GMHBA, Deakin Uni. There's tremendous scope for uptake of technology and improvement in businesses.
Smart solutions to everyday problems. We need more of them, don't we?
Exactly right, yes.
Oh, well, thank you so much for coming to talk to us and for this wonderful event. It really is fantastic. And for all the people in here today, I know they're going to take a lot out of it.
Excellent. Thank you very much. Okay.